Hi, I'm J.D. Gunnell with USU Extension. I'm one of the gardening experts. And we're here to talk about gardening today, just gardening 101, just some of the basic things behind growing your own produce. So when it comes to fertilizing your vegetables, keep in mind that the package doesn't have to say vegetable or tomato food. All you're concerned with is three numbers. The three numbers on the fertilizer bag represent nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. And if you're growing in a raised bed or a garden soil, most of the time you'll need a well-balanced fertilizer, one that has all three numbers. If you're growing in the ground, you can do a soil test through USU at the analytical lab, and they will tell you exactly what's in your soil and what fertilizers you need. Most top soils in Utah have plenty of phosphorus and potassium. You'll only need to add the nitrogen or the first number. Another consideration with fertilizer are these numbers or percentages. So when it says 12, 12, 12, for example, that's 12% nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. And most vegetables use a fair amount of fertilizer, but not as much as most people think. Some crops like peas and beans are legumes. They fix their own nitrogen, so you have to fertilize them very rarely. Other things like onions and corn, and even lettuce, are high nitrogen users. So make sure you do your homework and find out how much fertilizer each of these crops need. USU Extension has over 75 different individual fact sheets of each crop that you could grow with information on irrigation needs, fertilizer needs, row spacing, plant depth, all the information you would need about that specific crop. So check out these fact sheets at extension.usu.edu or garden.usu.edu.